You know your old Hollywood history. The Amazon's new series, The Last Tycoon, based on F. Scott Fitzgerald's unfinished novel, will look familiar, where Matt Bomer plays a wunderkind producer based on MGM production head Irving Thalberg. Kelsey Grammer plays his boss, a figure inspired by Louis B. Mayer. But the most fascinating character is probably Margot Taft, an actress played by Jennifer Beals who's concealing an explosive secret. The character is based on Merle Oberon, a Golden Age movie star who was known for her great beauty and the similar secret she took with her to the grave. In her time on Earth, starlet Merle Oberon lived a thousand lives with dark secrets that she tried to hide until the day she died. Though her devastating beauty propelled her to stardom, the scandalous circumstances of her birth haunted her throughout her life. It was only after her death that the truth was finally exposed. The striking beauty never let anyone else into her private life. So, watch this video to the end to find out what lies behind the curtains. And don't forget to smash the subscribe button for all of our interesting videos. Early life. Estelle Merle O'Brien Thompson was born in Bombay, British India on the 19th of February, 1911. Merle was given Queenie as a nickname in honor of Queen Mary, who visited India along with King George V in 1911. For most of her life, Merle protected herself by concealing the truth about her parentage, claiming that she had been born in Tasmania, Australia, and that her birth records had been destroyed in a fire. Merle Oberon's affairs and relationships might have sent Hollywood a titter during her adult life, but the starlet was quite literally born into scandal as well. While Oberon's birth certificate lists Arthur Terence O'Brien Thompson and Charlotte Selby as her parents, in reality, the truth was so much stranger and darker. White lies. Merle was raised as the daughter of Arthur Terence O'Brien Thompson, a British mechanical engineer from Darlington who worked in Indian railways, and his wife, Charlotte Selby, a Eurasian from Ceylon, Sri Lanka. Her mother also had Maori ancestry. However, according to her birth certificate, Merle's biological mother was Charlotte's then 12-year-old daughter, Constance. Charlotte had herself given birth to Constance at the age of 14, the result of rape by Henry Alfred Selby, the Anglo-Irish foreman of a tea plantation. To avoid scandal, Charlotte raised Merle as Constance's half-daughter. Constance eventually married Alexander Soares and had four other children, Edna, Douglas, Harry, and Stanislaus, or Stan. Edna and Douglas moved to the UK at an early age. Stanislaus was the only child to keep his father's surname of Soares and resided in Surrey, British Columbia, Canada. Harry eventually moved to Toronto, Canada, retaining Charlotte's maiden name, Selby. When Harry tracked down Merle's birth certificate in Indian government records in Bombay, he was surprised to discover that he was, in fact, Merle's half-brother, not her nephew. He attempted to visit her in Los Angeles, but she refused to see him. Harry withheld that information from Oberon's biographer, Charles Higham, and eventually revealed it only to Marie Delofsky, the creator of the 2002 documentary The Trouble with Merle, produced by the Australian Broadcasting Corporation, which investigated the various conflicting versions of Merle's origin. New Zealand author Witi Amira uses Oberon's hidden South Asian and Maori heritage as the inspiration for the novel White Lies, which was turned into the 2013 movie White Lies. Dropping out of school. These early years should have been some of the happiest of Oberon's life, but the bullying became so bad that she couldn't bear to attend the private school any longer. Oberon dropped out of school and began homeschooling with her mother. Despite these setbacks, this difficult time had one enormous silver lining. This was when Oberon fell in love with performing. Journey to Hollywood. Oberon's career took off after a move to London at age 17, when English director Alexander Korda cast her in a small but pivotal role as Anne Boleyn in The Private Life of Henry VIII in 1933. The film's success led to leading lady status and films, including The Scarlet Pimpernel, The Dark Angel, for which she was Oscar-nominated, That Uncertain Feeling, and A Song to Remember. But it was Oberon's personal story that was worthy of a Hollywood script. The actress, known more for her striking looks, often described as exotic, than her acting abilities, claimed she was born in Tasmania, like her contemporary Errol Flynn. She said that after her British Army officer father died, she was raised by her aristocratic Indian godparents. It's believed Corda, who became the first of Oberon's four husbands, concocted the fake origin story. Personal life. Oberon married director Alexander Korda in 1939. Still married, she had a brief affair in 1941 with Richard Hillary, an RAF fighter pilot who had been badly burned in the Battle of Britain. They met while he was on a goodwill tour of the United States. He later became well known as the author of a best-selling book, The Last Enemy. Oberon had an on-again, off-again affair with actor John Wayne from 1938 to 1947. Oberon became Lady Korda when her husband was knighted in 1942 by George VI for his contribution to the war effort. At the time, the couple was based at Hill's House in Denham, England. She divorced him in 1945 to marry cinematographer Lucian Ballard. Ballard devised a special camera light for her to eliminate, on film, her facial scars suffered in a 1937 accident. The light became known as the Obie. She and Ballard divorced in 1949. Oberon next married Italian-born industrialist Bruno Pagliai in 1957, adopted two children with him, and lived in Cuernavaca, Morelos, Mexico. In 1973, Oberon met then 36-year-old Dutch actor Robert Wolders while they filmed Interval. Oberon divorced Pagliai and married Wolders, who was 25 years her junior, in 1975. Final exit. Oberon retired after Interval and moved with Wolders to Malibu, California, where she died in 1979, aged 68, after suffering a stroke. Her body was interred at Forest Lawn Memorial Park Cemetery in Glendale, California. The Untold. To avoid prejudice over her mixed background, Oberon created a cover story of being born and raised in Tasmania, Australia, and her birth records being destroyed in a fire. The story eventually unraveled after her death. Oberon is known to have been to Australia only twice. Her first visit was in 1965 on a film promotion. Although a visit to Hobart was scheduled, after journalists in Sydney pressed her for details of her early life, she became ill and shortly afterward left for Mexico. In 1978, the year before her death, she agreed to visit Hobart for a Lord Mayoral reception. The Lord Mayor of Hobart became aware shortly before the reception that there was no proof she had been born in Tasmania, but to save face, went ahead with the reception. Shortly after arriving at the reception, Oberon, however, to the disappointment of many, denied she had been born in Tasmania. She then excused herself, claiming illness, and was unavailable to answer any more questions about her background. On the way to the reception, she had told her driver that as a child, she was on a ship with her father, who became ill when it was passing Hobart. They were taken ashore so he could be treated, and so she spent some of her early years on the island. During her Hobart stay, she remained in her hotel, gave no other interviews, and did not visit the theater named in her honor. Tributes. Oberon has a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame at 6250 Hollywood Boulevard for her contributions to motion pictures. Michael Korda, a nephew of Alexander Korda, wrote a roman à clef about Oberon after her death titled Queenie. This was adapted into a television miniseries starring Mia Sara. F. Scott Fitzgerald's unfinished novel, The Last Tycoon, was made into a television series, with Jennifer Beals playing Margot Taft, a character created for the TV series and based on Oberon. Although her private life attracted as much attention as her films, Oberon's beauty alone sustained her career into the 1950s, and she will be forever remembered for her striking acting portrayal of the tormented Kathy in the 1939 film version of Emily Bronte's Wuthering Heights. Find this video interesting? Do let us know in the comments below. And for more amazing videos, smash the red button to subscribe and the bell button to get notified.